Buffalo Experience is a all-day event with Jiu Jitsu, sauna, ice bath, breath work, new nutrition, and just a good time hanging out with amazing friends. You know, I think our modern society is pretty comfortable. We have it pretty good. And, you know, that's nice, but I think more of us, myself included, need to seek discomfort, because that's where the growth happens. Growth doesn't happen when you're cozy and comfortable. Growth happens when you're forced to stretch a little bit. And that's one of the intentions behind the Buffalo Experience, is stretching each other and being put in uncomfortable situations, uncomfortable environment.
It's about forming your bones into specific shapes. And sometimes you want to be a straight line, sometimes you want to be curved. We're going to make ourselves into gentle curves right now. So just lower your level, tuck your chin, slap at 45 degrees, and then we're just going to come on up. We're going to make ourselves into a triangle and stand up. Okay. So again, now that we're all standing up again, okay, lower your level. It's so important to tuck your chin. The most practical aspect of jiu-jitsu is actually in the falling skills, the protective skills, right? So tuck your chin, lower your level, hands out in front, and then rock back, be the ball. Then hand on the ground, leg goes back, and we're up. So this is a very basic exercise that teaches you to tuck your chin and how to become the ball. Sometimes you want to be the cube, sometimes you want to be the ball. So let's keep going with this for a few minutes on your own. Don't forget to tuck your chin. Arms out at 45, slap, not 90, 45. Off the hot part of the mat. Okay, so we're going to be in the guard position for those of you that are a little bit new. And one of my favorite ways to warm people up into the triangle is to just use some very subtle movements from the guard here. So I'm going to grab his cuff, four fingers in the cuff. My other hand goes to the lapel. Okay, my right foot is going to go on the ground. For the more advanced people, I still have contact with my knees on his torso. So it's not like, oh, I'm opening my guard. It's, I'm opening my guard, but there's still pressure on him. Move my hip out, I'm gonna swim my knee over, push his arm out of the way. There's a little pressure down with my heel as I raise up and hook over his shoulder. Okay, from here, I can bring my legs together, and it doesn't have to be perfect. You don't have to be perfect right away. I call this like the approximate triangle. Okay, then I'm gonna move that arm over, bring him down, grab my shin, foot on the hip, and then I finish with the triangle. Okay. On the other side, I'm putting my foot on the ground, move my hip out just enough, up and over. So I'm pushing on that bicep and breaking it. For the more advanced people, I'm engaging my hip here. I'm not just pushing with my knee. I'm throwing my hip into it. Okay. Bring the leg over and you want to cross. If it's only this, that's okay. If we're like this and we end up shooting our hip up, that's even better. Cross, okay? Bring the arm across. I pull him into me. Grab my shin. Once I grab my shin, that does the job of the other leg. So now I can let that go. Then I rotate 90 degrees or 45 or whatever you can do, and then cross, okay? One last time. So, foot on the ground, move the hip out. Push the bicep, go over the shoulder, cross your legs. Then, if that's all you can do, that's great. Bring that arm over, bring it down, and finish with the triangle. All right, guys, let's do it. One, two, three. There are many ways that you can get into that triangle position, so we'll go over a couple of different ones today. And triangle is fun because it doesn't take a lot of strength. Like, most people have enough strength in their legs to be able to choke someone out, which is, you know, a great way to spend the weekend. There are many ways you can do it. You can pull, and he pulls back, and I stuff it, and then I shoot up
into a triangle. You can also, there's some other ways. You can, last time we went outside and we pushed that arm out of the way. So what are we looking to achieve here? One arm in, one arm out. That's what we want. One arm in, one arm out. Okay. You can choke someone with just choking their neck, but if you have an arm in there, it really helps. It really helps. So this is a very practical technique. So last time we did outside, let's go inside now. Same thing, but now I windshield wipe. Okay. Now to make it a little bit easier to clear this, we're just going to knock him forward with that rear leg. Boom, then free your leg. And now we're back in triangle. Okay. So here we are, we're going to go inside, open out. Okay. I'm going to take my rear leg behind his armpit and pull him forward, make him base. Whenever you take their balance, or kazushi in Japanese, you want them to extend and open up. If they're all clammed up, you know, I'll never, if guys can be real tight and defensive. So the only, and you can't just pull, you can't use muscular strength to pry them open. You need to be able to attack something a little bit deeper. Physiologically, you want to attack their balance so they can't help but go into that, right? It's a very important concept. Okay, so one more time, foot on the ground, move the hip out. Open up that knee. Now I hit them from behind, clear the leg, and then you can finish. If you just want to go there, that's cool. If you want to really finish him off, grab your shin. This should be like heat-seeking missile. You want to find his hip rather than the floor. Find his hip, rotate, and if you still need a little bit more, you can rotate and kind of roll onto your shoulders and makes it extra tight. All right, guys, let's do it. One, two, three. I want to show you guys two techniques. Kind of basic. Hip bump is one of them, okay? Hip bump and triangle go really well together, even at like very high levels, because you powerfully off balance them and they have to catch their base with their hand. So hip bump is this. I swim up like I'm gonna grab his belt, but then I raise my hip off, driving from my rear leg, swipe this arm out of the way, and then tip him over. Okay, so this is hip bump. For those that don't, and there's a lot of different ways you can do it. You can just hold this and get him over. That's an easy way. You can do it coming off of the kimura. As he pulls up, I hold that arm and then go into it. Many, many different ways to do it. So let's just have you guys practice the hip bump, and you can do any kind of variation. One different variation for the more advanced players is I'm gonna push his arm there, and you see how his weight has shifted. Like, his hip is over his heel. That's what we want. We don't want his hip on top of his heel, then he's really well based. So I'm actually gonna push him, but he catches that, but that's okay, because then I can just pull it out. Finish something, right? So, give you three options for the hip bump. You can do just the traditional, I just come up on the hand. Hand is better than the elbow. Swipe out that tricep, pull it over. Variation number two, I do a kimura. Maybe I pull him in like this. And then he pulls up, I follow. Wrap that wrist. Take the hip off. Number three, for the more advanced people, grab the cuff, push him, and he catches. But I'm well positioned, so then I can just swipe that out. It's a trick. He thinks he caught his balance, but we're one step ahead. Okay? So hip bump with your partners. One, two, three. An excellent self-defense move. It's very simple, very powerful. If you have somebody in between your legs or inside the guard, as we say, you know, being able to do something like this and then to be able to extract yourself from a situation is powerful and effective. I've used that all the way through my jiu-jitsu training on all kinds of people, particularly when they're like postured really hard back, really, really, and then you're like, oh my God, how am I gonna do this? can do it kind of shallow, or sometimes they're so into like keeping like really strong posture, they're going back, that you can go over that shoulder and take them. So hip bump is really good. Also, it sets up beautifully for that triangle. Okay, so we're gonna go into our hip bump, kind of a basic here. Up on the hand, I'm telling you, the hand is where it's at. He catches, my hand comes back, I scrape along the ground with my leg, and now we're back into a triangle. Okay. On the other side, I come up to the hand. I really have to disrupt his balance. I'm not gonna get my knee past that elbow unless I make a real move. He catches, pull that leg out low to the ground, and then we have one arm in, one arm out for triangle. Very common to do this, but then I try bringing my leg up, and that's difficult. It gets caught in the arm. So bring it low along the ground, pop that hip, bring it over, do all your adjustments, finish with a wrist lock rather than a triangle if you want, okay? Let's do that hip bump into the triangle. One, two, three. To get the triangle, typically you have to get the person to the ground. So let's go over some easy ways of getting the person to the ground. This is a little bit of judo, where BJJ came from. And this exercise that we did where we tuck our chin and turn ourselves into a ball, that's gonna come into play here, because we're gonna tuck our chin and slap the mat. Now, not with both arms, but we'll eventually be just slapping with one arm. So what am I trying to do? I'm trying to diffuse the force. You know, if I fall back and I land all my weight and momentum on a single point, it's gonna hurt. So I wanna just disperse that as much as possible. Hand on the waist, arm out at 45 degrees in line with the femur, chin tucked, okay? Let's have everybody just on their back like this. Okay. And we're centered. Then we're gonna lay our left hand down and our left femur down on the ground, right hand at the belt line, okay? Then we're just gonna raise our hip up a little bit and switch to the other side. Now make sure that center foot, or that the top leg has the sole of the foot in the ground. And then we switch again. Good. Try to bring the hands, try to have it all coordinated. One sound. Nice, hey, looking better. Again. Good. Right. Left. Right. Left. Damn, congrats, that was nice. That was good. Okay, so now let's stand up and practice falling just to that side. You can just go back and just pick one side, okay? Just fall back and pick one side to slap to. Go. Three. Good, on your own. Be the ball. If you wanna be a really good jiu-jitsu player or teacher, you have to be a great student. And it's important to never give that up. I took some private lessons from a guy named Justin Flores, who's a USA Olympic judo coach and just total stud. So I wanted him to show me a few things about Osoto Gari, which is Osoto is major reaping throw, okay? So I essentially want to hook this leg and then kick it out. Boom, look at that, right there, okay? And he taught me a little trick, which applies to a principle I've been exploring. When you want motion on this side, you initiate it on the opposite side of your body. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a little kick. We're gonna do a little kick and then hook. And we're not even gonna take them over. Don't worry about the arms or anything. We're just gonna do a little. If I do this, that's slow. But if I do this, it's faster. It's about continuous momentum. Okay. So just a little flutter kick and then hook. You want your toes pointed. You wanna turn these into little hooking paddles right there, okay? So we're just gonna flick our leg out and then hook behind the knee. Got that? All right, one, two, three. think about. Okay, so what we're gonna do here, I really love this variation of it he showed me. Typically, we're like stepping in, pulling the guy off balance, throwing down, devastating throw. Very cool variation is to initiate with that little flick of the foot here, but I'm not even parallel with him. Then I hop, and then we take him down. Okay. So this is kind of cheating, especially for people with longer legs. Doing the other side. Especially if he's like stiff arming me, whatever. I can't get in, I can't turn. That's my short-term goal right there. Then I hop. Then take him down, and I'm controlling his fall a little bit with my grips, and he's also pulling my lapel and slowing his fall. So just play around with this. I'm doing this side. So a little flick, kick, 1, 2, 3. Then it should feel really easy to bring our partner down. Okay? Let's play with it. 1, 2, 3. Like this variation of Osoto Gari. It works much better for me. Very often when you start jiu-jitsu, you want to reverse a position in one move. You know, but life isn't like that. Sometimes you gotta make small moves, intermediate steps, short-term goals, medium-term goals. That's like a short-term goal, just hook my leg. And then I'll see what's up and follow through. But you don't have to do it all at once. That's for life or for anything. All right, so now let's finish with a little arm lock here. So we can initiate just a little movement. Oh, there I am, bump. Take him down, keep lifting. He's still holding on to me, right? So I'm gonna wrap that. As soon as I step over, I wrap, but I'm still lifting. I'm lifting, knees come together. Doesn't matter how far out your ankles are. The pinch is what matters. And then hold on to that wrist and take your arm off. I'm still holding on to that elbow. So just small initiation. Bump. We're here, small circle with the leg. Don't step out here. I mean, you can for safety. You can, but then you have to pull your heel all the way back in and take the arm lock. One more time. Knees together. I can't tell you how important that is. Up here. Nice and tight. Let's do it. 1, 2, 3. I think it's a beautiful throw. I think it's very practical. Guys, it's kind of like top five throws in competition, so it's a pretty high percentage. And very often, even though many things look cool, you don't want to like fall prey to martial vanity, where you're like, I want to do that because that looks cool. You have to play the percentages on what is going to work with your body type and how much you've practiced moves. Whenever you're in competition, you actually want to go to your comfort zone as quickly as possible, the familiar positions, so that you can hit your familiar submissions. Don't have some daydream scenario. I've done that before where I'm like, oh, I'll do a rolling knee bar and then I'll do this and that. And it doesn't work out like that. It's good to visualize, but you want to not think about looking cool. You should think about it. A properly executed technique always looks cool. Okay, so let's do a throw. I'll show you what the throw is. It's called Tai Otoshi, side body drop. Okay, and I'm going to show you just a couple of ways that I've seen this done. I'm not going to throw TJ. I've seen this done where you just make a basic triangle. Okay, and he's going to trip over my ankle here. Okay, I've seen that done with a flat foot. I've seen it done with toes up, so there's like a little pop in your knee. There was a guy in Japan who, I mean, he would go like this, like really low. And when I was younger, I thought, oh, I have to get really low like that. I have to do it just like they do it. You have to do it like you need to do it. You have to make the appropriate shape for you. And sometimes this hand, over the years, I found, you know, it's good to push the guy, but sometimes this is not that easy to get. I actually think it's easier to do this. Put the forearm in the crook of his elbow. So So we're here, and we just trip them over. Okay. So if this arm collapses, it's no good, because I don't want it to be like head and arm throw where I'm pulling him into me, onto me. I actually want to project him out a little bit. So the first thing we're going to do is a plank, so that we can, and just everyone go to a plank position right now. So you can feel extension through your forearms, shoulders. Yeah, that's good. Good. Up on one. That's good. Up on the other. That's good. Two. Nice. Okay. Everyone back up. I want you to feel that. You're extending through with both sides. Okay. Now we're not going to throw. What we're going to do is I'm going to do a little trick. I'm going to grab his cuff. I'm going to push it across. When he pulls back, I'm going to enter. And you don't have to have your ankle up or anything. You just want to get your foot right past his foot. That's it. Okay. We're going to push this across. When he pulls back, I'm going to step into position. Now, let me break down that footwork a little bit. Okay. I step in the middle. I swing out to the side. And finally, I make my adjustment step. Okay. Step in the middle. Swing out to the side. Make your adjustment step. Okay? Let's just do that with our partners. Yeah, you have a question?
One more time.
Yeah, absolutely. Push it across. I step to the middle. Step to the side. Adjust. Okay, let's do it. What do you do? Have you, like many throws in judo, have you becoming one body? And he's right on top of me, right on top of my back. This one, I want to actually push him to the side. I want it to be off angle. So I don't want to have him, I don't want that heel up too much. I'm much more into like all the weight into that, into the sole of the foot. And I don't want to have my hip obstructing him too much. I actually want to just get my ankle past his, that's it. I don't want to bust his knee by going backwards. I just want, it's a trip. It's just, jiu-jitsu is pushing, pulling, and blocking. And this is the block. So if you're feeling like it, you can just trip them, but only if it's just over your ankle. All right? Just over your ankle. Okay. Not the full body mass rotation. Just over the ankle. Okay. A few more minutes, then we'll break for lunch, okay? One, two, three. Okay. Yeah. Thanks for your attention. I hope that was fun. There's something kind of magical about taking somebody's balance, but also having your balance taken, you know, and feeling safe in that, because you trust your training partners, you trust the mat. It's good to lose control every once in a while. Not too much, but every once in a while. So judo is something that you should look at as not a separate art, but it's part of jiu-jitsu. And wrestling is just compressed jiu-jitsu, compressed in time limits, compressed in its goal. It only has like really one goal, pinning their shoulders on the mat as opposed to what we do in jiu-jitsu. But you know, the arts change, wrestling is an art, all these arts change depending on the rules and how people evolve to win, which is what we ultimately want to do. You know, so this is an art that can be practiced as a sport, and keep an open mind with some of the sister arts, sambo, judo, wrestling, and even yoga. So I appreciate your attention today, and looking forward to the afternoon session. Thank you, guys. Okay, so nothing out there could ever stop me from chasing after the way you la 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 love me, keeping me up two cups of coffee. Baby, you make me feel so la 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 lovely. I keep on wanting, no, I shouldn't want it. I keep on pulling right until you're gone. I can't get you out.